Good morning, everyone. Welcome to your English class. Today, we are going to do lesson number 25, that is letter writing. Children, letter is a message that can be sent to relatives, friend or any official. Okay, so it's a essential communication. It's a communication through pen and paper and ink that reaches the addressee by a postal system. Okay, so we have two types of letters, informal letter and formal letter. So I'll tell you about first of all informal letter. An informal letter is a letter when you're writing to your family members, your friends, your relatives. So it's written in a friendly tone, you can say, or a personal tone, right? Like contractions, like he's, you are, it can be used in this type of letters. So informal letters include social letters and note of invitations or suggestion you can give, right? And second is formal type of letter. And formal letter is written to obtain or give information about your school, your business, your employment, or you have to place an order of books. Okay, so its language should be clear and to the point. So we are not going to use contractions here. So formal letters include business letters, official letters, job application, then letter to the editor of the newspapers, to the manager of a company, to the publisher or to the principal. Okay, so mainly letter has four main parts. First is beginning, second is salutation, third is body, and fourth is ending. So children, in the beginning, in this part of the letter, beginning, the letter includes the writer's address and also the date of writing the letter if it is informal. And in business letter, it includes reference number and it is put on the extreme left on the top, right? And salutation is, in this part of the letter, it includes formal words to address the person to whom you are writing a letter. Like the words are written according to the relationship with the person. So they are also written on the extreme left part below the beginning of the letter. Like if you are writing to your principal, so it would be like Reverend Sister, Respected Sir. Okay. And if it is to your friends, you will write Dear so and so, your name of your friend. Like I'll write Dear Seema, Dear Rahul. Then if it is to your relatives or to your family members, you could start like this, Dear Mother, Dear Father. And if it is to the person to whom you know, you will say, My Dear Sharma, My Dear Sethi Ji, Dear Mr. Sharma, right? And if the person is not known to you, he's a stranger. So you will write sir, dear madam. Okay. Then is the body of the letter. In this part, the letter contains the message that the writer wants to convey. And it is written at the extreme left just below the salutation. So it will contain the message that you want to convey. Okay. And then is ending. In this part, the letter contains the final leave-taking words of the writer and his or her signature. Okay, I'll show you the specimen of a letter in the last first unit test. You have had this informal letter. I have told you the format of an informal letter. Now in this video, I'm going to show you the specimen of a formal letter. So now children, we are writing an application to the principal of our school for fee concession. Now how you will start? You'll start from the margin that is given on the left side of your notebook. You'll start from there. Do not start from in between. So do not start from the middle. Okay, you will use this left part. So when you are writing to the principal, your T should be capital and your P should be capital. And you often make mistake in the spellings. You write P-L-E, but the spellings of principal is P-R-I-N-C-I-P-A-L. Then we will write the name of the school. And the name of your school is Christ the King Convent School. Here you have to note that all the letters, first letter of all the words will be capital except this the. Here T should be small. Christ C should be capital. The T should be small. K capital. Convent C capital. And school S capital. Then we will write the name of the city, that is Pathankot, P capital. And we will not put any comma or full stop over here. Right? After leaving one margin, leaving one line, you will write the date. Date when you are writing a letter on an application. That is 29 August I am writing here. You will write according to you whenever you are writing letter. So 29th August and you will put comma here and then year 2021. Then again you have to leave one line and you will write subject. Subject that what is the purpose of writing this application. So application for fee concession. Then again you will leave one line and you will write Reverend Sister. Please note down students, you have to write Reverend Sister. Do not write Respected Sister. This is the format we are going to follow. So you will write R capital, S capital, Reverend Sister. Then you will put comma and you will not leave any margin now. And in the next line you will start writing your letter. So most respectfully, I submit that I am a student of class 6. Now you will mention your section also here, right? I have great interest in studies. So I am in the good books of all the teachers. Means I am good in studies and all teacher they like me. Like I am a good student, right? So my father's income is very less. Here you have to mention that why you are not able to pay the fee. Okay. For what you are asking concession, what is the reason? So my father's income is very less, but he has a large family to support. He is unable to pay my school fee. So because of this reason, he is not able to pay my school fee. So it is becoming difficult for me to carry on my studies due to lack of funds. So in the absence of due to lack of money, so I'm not able to carry my studies and I'm not able to continue my studies. So comma, I request you to grant me full fee concession. I shall be very thankful to you for this kindness. So your letter is complete, application is complete here. Then in the next line you will write thanking you, and then you leave line and write yours truly, yours faithfully, yours affectionately, yours obediently. You can use any here. And you have to keep in mind this thing that Y should be capital, F should be small, and you will put comma here after writing faithfully, truly, affectionately. And in the next line you will write your name. Like your name could be X, Y, Z, or Rahul, Seema, whatever you want to write. So X.